In this video, I'm going to walk you through the film impact motion effects. With motion effects, you can create beautiful animations inside Premiere Pro without the use of any keyframes. Let's start with the simple Ken Burns effect, where still images are slowly zoomed in or out to create a sense of motion. Let's create a Ken Burns effect right within Premiere Pro. I have two clips sitting here. In the effects library, I'm gonna look for the grow effect and drag it onto my first clip. And now play it back. The zoom starts automatically and I haven't applied any keyframes. So on the next clip, I'm gonna look for shrink. And again, out of the box behavior, the zoom starts automatic. What I'm gonna do is select the clip in the timeline, head over to the effects controls tab and select the video effect here. A little crosshair comes up and this is the zoom point. So this is the exact location where the zoom is going to. And I'm gonna place it onto the subject so you get a more effective zoom. And the same thing we're gonna do for the second clip and see how that works. All right, beautiful. Now click the cut in between, and what I'm gonna do is apply the film impact dissolve and see how that works. So we slowly move to the second clip. This effect gives life to static pictures, making them more engaging and pleasing to the eye. Moving on to spin effects. For this example, I have a round logo, and this is perfect for adding a spin. Let's look for spin effects. Drag it on top of the logo and out of the box behavior. The logo starts spinning. And what I'm gonna do now is look for the spin effects in the effects controls tab. And I wanna demonstrate the difference between the continuous mode and the destination mode. So continuous mode will give a certain spin in degrees per second. And it will just continue to spin. And it doesn't matter whether this clip is like 8 seconds long or 16 seconds long or whatever, it will continuously spin. With the destination mode, let's switch to destination mode. I now have an initial spin degree. And this means that by the start of a clip, we're starting out with 0 degrees, moving through the clip. By the end, we spin around by 360 degrees. And another cool thing here is the Bezier curve. Let's add the ease out to say 55 and start spinning. And while this effect is spinning, it will gradually slow down until it's almost reached the 360 degrees. And remember, all animations in this video tutorial are created entirely with film impact video effects. Let's move on with moving objects. In this example, I have a red location marker and I want it to move up and down so we can emphasize the exact location. For this, I'm going to look for move effects in the effects library and drag this onto the graphic. Let's change to destination mode. And now we can set the exact initial position and the target position. So let's do that. Put the playhead at the beginning of the frame and have the exact position where we start. Then go to the last frame, the object, and move it down just a little bit there, right there, and see if this works. We start here and we end there, perfect. So all we need to do now is make it pulsate. And therefore we change the curve graph to the pulsate curve. Here now it's bouncing up and down, and let's make it multiple bounces. So set the frequency to 10 and see what happens. You see the motion marker now moving up and down. We can change the easing of this curve type. So I'm gonna lower the ease base to 0 and that will give it that extra bounce at the bottom. Perfect. Now we know the exact location. Next up, we're gonna add some 3D rotations. In this example, I'm going to use 3D rotation to really give the phone that 3D look and feel. I'm gonna look for 3D rotate effects and apply it to the phone element. And out of the box behavior, this element starts spinning in 3D automatic. I'm gonna move back the playhead just at the beginning of the animation and set the right axis here. So what I'm gonna do is make it 135 about-ish. And that works, right? Let's change it to destination mode. And with the destination mode enabled, I can set the initial rotation. Let's set it at minus 40. And now seeing the overlay, let's enable auto crop. And now the plugin knows the exact position of the phone element. And again, play with the initial rotation and see how the plugin knows the exact position and set the target position, which also is visible right here. And I'm gonna be subtle with this. So maybe 10 or 12 is enough for the entire animation. This makes a very subtle feeling of 3D. So even though we're not playing it back, I can see the final position of the element. And right here, I'm happy with this. Let's have that playback. Add some ease out to make a smooth ending there. Let's make the animation stop right after 5 seconds. Again, look for the Effects Controls tab and open the Timing section. I'm going to enable durations, and since the units are in seconds, I can just add a duration of 5 seconds for halfway the clip length. This means we have limited the animation to cover only the first half of the clip. After these 5 seconds, the rotation stops and the phone will stay in its final position. That's it, a 3D animation that really emphasizes the graphic element. A common issue that you may encounter when using the motion effects is cropping. And what do I mean by that? When I add a grow effect to the map element, I can kind of see the grow happening, but it's cropped, it's not expanding, it's as you may expect. So what's happening? When we open this in Photoshop, I can try and enlarge it, but I kind of have the same problem here. So this is the exact thing we're looking at. So what we could do is enlarge the canvas. So let's do that and change it to like 200%. There you go. And now we've enlarged the canvas, right? I would be very careful with this solution. And this is the reason why. The image size now is above 12,000 pixels in width and 16,000 pixels in height. And this image alone already requires more than 3 gigs of dedicated and precious video RAM. So avoid this solution at all time. Let's do another method, is by shrinking the image right within its canvas, and now it has some space around it to do the grow, right? But there's a smarter solution, and it's sitting right within the plugin itself. Let's move back to Premiere Pro. I'm gonna select the clip and go to the grow effects, and there's a pre-transform section right here. And when I enable it, it scales automatically by 50%. And that means to get it back on the original scale, I can double the scaling amount right here, and we're back on track. And now the video effect has enough room to do the actual grow. In general, we recommend your image resolutions should not exceed your project resolutions. The next and final effect I want to demonstrate is spacer effect, and that is the icing on the cake. One of the hidden gems in the motion effects series is spacer effect. When I apply this to text, you'll see each character slowly getting out of position. So let's show that by looking for spacer effects and apply it to the text element. By default, it starts growing automatically and taking up more space. And we can reverse the direction just by checking the reverse direction checkbox. And there you go. It starts shrinking automatically. And this is a very subtle effect and very powerful for movie introductions and so forth. This effect will try and isolate each object with transparency around it. And that is very effective for various kinds of graphics. Download the entire Film Impact library and unleash your creativity. It's yours, free, for 30 days.